Hello friends, welcome to learn Microsoft Excel. Today we are going to learn filter. Okay, to filter data we have here number of records. Here I put turn year by 20 records. Then how to use filter? You can use filter by two ways. You can go to home, first select the data, then you can go to home and choose here sort and filter, or you can go to data and click on filter. Okay, here the filter is applied. What is the use of this filter? Filter is used to sort out the data very easily or to separate the data as per the criteria. Suppose here we have a filter. For example, we want data only. We want data only employee number 103 and 105. Here is the data. Okay. Then, if you want to print this data, you can easily print this. You don't need to go to on separate sheet and put the data separately. Okay. Again, select all. Okay. You have all data. Suppose we have to check only the data of some employees. Okay, here is the data of some employees. Therefore, filter is very useful for feature. Okay, now here we want to data only for administration department. Okay, here is the data is present only from administration department. Okay, like this you can filter data. If you want to see data who's having salary 15,000, okay, as well as you can also sort and filter the department. Now here I have one sheet, and in this sheet we have some rules. Okay, first list all the details for people in administration department. We have seen this. Then list all the details for people in marketing department. Now here the next point is list all the details of people in production or purchase department. In this case, you can go to department, use production, purchase and production. Here are the details. Then again, here is the symbol of filter. Go there and click on select all. Okay. Let us see next. List all the details of people in marketing department who join in company after 19 something, but here we have joined year as from 2000. Therefore, we want to filter the data from marketing department. Let us first filter data from marketing department. Okay, the join year is 2005, 18, 10, 18. Okay, now if we want to display the record before employee joined before the 18, then how to go there? For that, you have to go to custom filter, go to number filter and go to custom filter. And here you can set before 18. It means what? Less than 2018. Click on OK. What happened? Let us see. Join date, number filter, custom filter. Before 18, we want before 18, therefore less than. Joined it less than 2018. Here is the filter of data. Okay. Now again go here, select all. Again go first filter, select all. Then you have whole data. Now the next rule is list all the people in administration and marketing department. Okay. Then list all people drawing a salary greater than 1500. Here we have salary in 1000. Therefore, let us check the employee having salary more than 15,000. Then again go to number custom filter and greater than equal to 15,000. Okay, here is the record. clear. Now again go to select all. The next rule is you can set criteria as per your requirement. Details of people in administration department whose salary is more than 10,000 suppose. Then first you have to sort out department, filter the department of only administration. I mean salary more than 2,000 or 15,000, but here let us use 10,000. Then custom filter. Salary is greater than or equal to, not equal to, only greater than 10,000. Okay. Like this you can easily filter the data. Okay. Again go to department. Select all. Okay. Now the next one is count how many people administration and marketing department who have joined after 1983. Okay. First select the people from my administration and marketing and then check who joined from some year. Let us first select from marketing and administration department. Okay. The year is 2000, 2005, 15, 18, 10, 8, 18, 10. Okay. And let us find people who joined from 2005. Then here, go to number filter, custom filter, greater than 2005. Okay. And as well as we have to count people. Okay. Then how to count it? For counting people, you can use here count function equal to count in bracket enter. Bracket is wrong. Again, okay. Here the function is not work, then how to check it? Let us copy this data and paste in another location. And now here you can use counting operation. Let us undo it. We have to first have department, administration, and suppose marketing, and then join after 2005. That is greater than 2005. Okay. Greater than 2005. Okay. Now again. You select all. Now the next criteria is people for administration department drawing salary 1,000 to 2,000. Okay, then let us for first select the people from administration department. Salary is 1,000 to 10,000. Let us select one another department. Suppose here we use marketing. Okay, now 10,000, 10,000, 18,000, 12,000. Okay, now here we can give criteria. Custom salary is greater than equal to suppose 12,000 and here use less than equal to 18,000. Then there are only three records. Okay, like this you can also give an or condition. Again, select all record. After that, display details of employee greater than 12. Employee code is greater than 12. You can easily filter it. Display details of people in admission sales department and also find the total salary distributed to them. For this purpose, we have to use another sheet. Here, I put data in this sheet also. Okay. Now here, First we want, let us read it again. Admission and sales department, and find the total salary distribute to them. Okay. Then first sort out administration and marketing department. Okay, then sort this data first. And now for distributing salary, to check sum of salary, we have to use here subtotal. Go to data, and here data we have subtotal. Okay, let us see the whole range. We want to department and salary. Then go to data, subtotal. Then here, change display in department. The function is which function? Salary, sum, sorry. And we want to add a total of salary. Click on OK. Here is the total of salary. Okay. This is filter data, therefore it will show like this. Let us select the whole range, and now the change department wise we want to check some of salaries, and it changes display on department. Okay. No, it's not right. How to check subtotal? Let us see it. Let us copy this data. Let us copy this data. Go to new sheet. Simply paste data, and then let us calculate the subtotal. Okay, here it will ask us column labels. Let us copy column labels. Okay, now select data, go to data, subtotal. We want to add each change in department. We want to total of salary. Okay, now here is the perfect subtotal. Total 60,000 distributed to administration, and total of 52,000 distributed to marketing. Like this, you can use the subtotal. Okay, now you can easily filter it. Here you have to select 3 years. Then display all the details of employee, expect administration. Okay, for this again, go to filter, select all. Okay, now here go to custom filter, and here you can select does not equal to administration. Okay, then all the records except administration department. Okay, and find the details of salary distributed in each of the department separately. For this, I here created sheet 2. Then again, go to subtotal. Let us select it. Then go to data, subtotal the same way, change in department, and we want to add sum of salary. Okay, sorry, before that let us sort it. Data, sort data. Ascending, sort department A to Z. Okay, here is the sorting of department. Then select the whole range, go to data, subtotal, each change in department, want to sum of salary. Okay, now here is the salary for administration department, finance, marketing, production, purchase. You can also minimize it. Okay, and you want to expand it, you can easily expand it like this. You can use filter, sort, and subtotal. Okay, here is very simple topic, but you have to practice it. Okay, thank you for watching the lecture. We will continue in next lecture.